let's take a look at our first Java cup. Now, why is it called Java? Why did Sun Microsystems call this programming language Java? And if you see right there in the PowerPoint, you see that there's a cup of coffee with a few red steam, right? Because Java came from the concept of coffee. Okay, it's actually a mixture of chocolate, espresso, and yes, that's true, Josh. No? It means coffee, but it's a mixture of chocolate, milk, and espresso. Okay, why do developers like to learn Java aside from, you know, drinking coffee? Because Java is a powerful object-oriented programming language. When you say object-oriented programming language, there's a lot of what we call OOPL, object-oriented programming language, OOPL. And some of them, I think some of you already knows Python, right? So if you know a little bit of Python, I think Josh said that he knows a little bit of Python. And Python is also an object-oriented programming language. C sharp. I saw earlier that some of you are using Visual Studio. Probably you're already versed with C sharp. And C sharp is also an object-oriented programming language. Same thing is true with Java. But Java has been around since May 1995. And it's a very powerful object-oriented programming language that even 25 years after its creation, it's still here. It's been used widely, specifically for web apps. If you have an Android device, chances are the back end of your Android mobile phone is running on Java. Josh said he also knows HTML and CSS. That's a very good language specifically for web applications. But for Java, one of the reasons why people started learning this language and other OOPLs, it's because of the three main features, namely encapsulation, inheritance, and polymorphism. Now, when we say encapsulation, it has something to do with data protection. Okay? In all OOPL, C#, Java, Python, there's always a concept of encapsulation which allows you to protect your data. You encapsulate your data from direct access. So we can say that Java is secured, all right? We don't just create codes that can be exposed to anybody that can see them. Now, when we talk about inheritance, you don't have to write everything from ground up. Imagine this. Let's say you're a programmer and you have created, let's say, a credit card application, an application that accepts payments using a credit card. Now, after doing that application, you've started writing a web app that will probably, let's say, it's an online store, all right? It's a web application that you can use to sell applications or books or video games online. Of course, if you try to sell something online, you'll be needing the credit card application that you have created in the previous project. You can now reuse that. You can also inherit that on your online store application. So when you create another application, let's say you've created a hotel reservation system where people can check in a hotel and then they can do all hotel reservation online, which means they can also pay online. You don't need to rewrite the credit card application that you've written in the previous project. You can simply reuse them. And the concept of inheritance is basically the concept of reusability. So in Java, you don't have to write everything from ground up. There are already ready-made applications. There are already ready-made methods for that you can simply reuse. All right? And of course, we have the concept of polymorphism. Now, all these three features, encapsulation, inheritance, and polymorphism, are not just a part of the Java programming language. They are an essential part of all object-oriented programming languages such as Python, Java, C#, okay, and even Ruby, okay? Now, another feature that I enjoyed in Java is it's very simple to learn. Okay, the syntax is similar to C++. And there are some concepts in C and in C++ that are very tedious and very hard to learn, like the concept of pointers. I remember when I was still a student in college, when my teacher talks about pointers, I will always say, teacher, is it possible for me just to use arrays instead of pointers? Because using pointers is quite, you know, hard, and it's quite challenging when it comes to understanding the concept of pointers. But in Java, the good news is we don't have pointers anymore. What we have are reference values. So reference values is a little bit of an advanced topic that we cannot dive into right now. So we'll just stick with the simple version of Java. So if you already have a background in C and C++, this should be a very easy language for you to migrate on.
Be sure to join TechDev Academy's workshops and camps, and also read some great articles on their blog page.